This is Lenny Farlee, Purdue University Extension Forester. Now let's ID that tree. Today we're going to give you some identification clues for red or slippery elm. We have some different species of elm here in Indiana: American elm, red elm, and in southern Indiana, winged elm, and in a few locations, rock elm. And they can become confusing. By far, our two most common species are American and red or slippery elm. And we're going to give you some characteristics on this one to help you identify it in comparison to American. So red or slippery elm tends to be a species that I find more on upland areas, where American elm will oftentimes be in moister soils or even in valleys and river bottoms or creek bottoms. However, we can find red elm occasionally in the same places. Red elm can also get to be a little bit bigger tree oftentimes in Indiana, because it's still susceptible to some of the same diseases that kill American elm, but I will find it sometimes getting to be up to 2 feet in diameter or larger in some upland locations, where it's kind of an individual tree rather than a group of trees that might share disease. As is the case with all our elms, red elm has alternate leaf arrangement and simple leaves on very short leaf stems attached to the twigs. The twigs have a tendency, when they mature, to be a kind of light gray-brown with slightly darker buds. The tops of the leaf surface will tend to be very sandpapery once the leaves mature about midsummer. As is also the case with most of our elms, they have doubly serrate tooth margins, and so there's a large tooth with smaller teeth on top of that large tooth. The bark of red or slippery elm has a tendency to have strong upright ridges or plating. And another characteristic that helps us differentiate this from American elm is the fact that the inner bark on red or slippery elm has alternating light and dark bands of brown, where in American elm there are alternating bands of light tan and dark reddish brown, much more striking than red elm. So thinking about slightly larger leaves, very sandpapery texture on top, the strong ridging on the bark, the dark banding inside the bark will help you differentiate this species, slippery elm, from American elm.